السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us, really, sitting here for Salatul Taraweeh for a period of more than 1 hour is no joke. One requires lots of sincerity. And at the same time, thereafter sitting for a lecture for an hour or more than an hour every single day is also no joke. It requires great sincerity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. The month of Ramadan, this is how it is supposed to be spent. We are meant to be having sleepless nights in the month of Ramadan. We are meant to be suffering lack of sleep because we should be livening up the month or the nights in the month of Ramadan. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all acceptance. The topic we have chosen tonight, something every single one of us engage in on a daily basis, speech. To talk how we speak and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about speech in the Quran. It's amazing. The mouth is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You enter the fold of Islam through the mouth, and may Allah protect us, people exit the fold also through their mouths. People utter either good words or bad words. Let's take a look at the verses that we have clustered together tonight from the Quran connected to the speech. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, firstly, to begin with, in Surah Qaf. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِن قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Indeed, with every single person, as they are uttering their words, there is one who is keeping record, ready to do that, subhanallah. So before you utter a word, there is already an angel ready to write those words down. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection. That is the beginning of this topic. So before we utter words, we should know someone is writing these words down. And this is really from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know, when a person is arrested by the law enforcement agents, known as the police, what happens? They are told, listen, you have the right to remain silent. Anything you utter may be held against you in the court of law, correct? So now when people say, what's your name? They say, see my lawyer. When someone says, what did you do? See my lawyer. They make sure they don't want to make a mistake because they don't want a single word to be held against them in a court that might jail them for a short period of time. Why then are we not worried about the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah, which might jail us for a long, long time? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. We fear little people of the dunya without being able to fear the creator of this entire dunya, subhanallah. So that is the message Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with. Then He commands us that when you use the gift that you have, speech is a gift. Some people don't have it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant those who are challenged in that way, may He grant them the ability to speak, inshallah. Some people cannot speak. May Allah grant them the ability to speak. We remember them on this eve and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them cure. But the speech is a gift of Allah. Ask those who don't have it. They won't be able to even tell you Allahu Akbar except through signs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, consider it a gift. And only choose your words carefully to make sure that you utter the best of words. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra. وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Tell my worshippers, instruct my worshippers to only utter that which is the best. The term ahsan, ahsan means afdal, the best of language. So whenever we speak, it is our duty as Muslims to make sure we have regarded this gift of speech as a real gift, and we have uttered only that which is the best. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in a different way in Surah Al-Baqarah, as well as, in fact, in the same surah twice, Allah says, choose your words carefully when you speak. Do not be disrespectful. Listen to what Allah says.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقُولُوا رَاعِنَا وَقُولُوا انظُرْنَا وَاسْمَعُوا.
O you who believe, When you utter words, make sure that you do not use the disrespectful term, such as Ra'ina. Ra'ina was a disrespectful term, which was full of disrespect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't use that word. Rather, use words that are full of respect. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. The message of this verse is that whenever we want to say something, we should make sure we say it in a respectful manner. It will keep the dignity of ourselves intact. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in a narration, do not use difficult language to try and show the prowess, to try and show your command of the language. No, use simple language that everyone can understand, inshallah. That's a hadith, that's a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, none of them used complicated language, none of them. They all used simple language. Also, the hadith says, stay away from slang because it will reduce your respect. Subhanallah. Stay away from slang, no matter what language it is. Slang will reduce your respect. Let's try and fulfill the sunnah. Wallahi, I tell you, it will enhance our respect, inshallah. It might not be haram to speak slang, but at the same time, if you want to be a respectful person, speak clear cut in the language that you are speaking, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us like those. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, whenever you speak, make sure what you utter is upright. It is the truth. It is full of justice.
Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum a'malakum wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum.
O you who believe, be conscious of your Creator and make sure that you only utter that which is upright, that which is true, that which is full of dignity, that which is just. And if you are to do that, your deeds will be made acceptable, number one. Number two is, Allah will forgive your sins just because you've uttered words which are upright. Now, there is no coincidence that this word, or these verses, should I say, are repeated when a person is getting married in the khutbah. In that khutbah, this verse is repeated. I'm sure a lot of us have heard this. It's not a coincidence because 99% of marital problems are connected to the way we've used our tongues. 99% of our marital problems are connected to how we've used our tongues. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us conscious of what we say. It is our duty as spouses to say words to our spouses and family members that will make them smile, that will make them happy, that will make them feel loved on a daily basis, subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do that as well. And he used to utter very good words, decent words, which used to make his spouses blush at times, subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who can revive even that sunnah. Sometimes people think sunnah is only when you dress according to Islam. Then the rest of their lives, they are not worried. Allahu Akbar. They come home like lions. They come home like a cat and mouse show. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. That's not what should be happening. The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is an entire lifestyle. Let us try and adopt as much of it as we can, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says that sometimes you need to speak in a hard tone. Sometimes you need to speak in a powerful, strong tone, in an effective manner. It is called al-qawlul baligh. And this is important that we understand. Whenever there are people who need admonishment, then you cannot smile at them and speak softly and try and, you know, make the issue very light when it is a serious issue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the hypocrites. And Allah says in Surah An-Nisa, فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ وَعِظْهُمْ وَقُلْ لَهُمْ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ قَوْلًا بَلِيغًا. Turn away from them. Warn them, admonish them, and tell them in a very effective way that will go straight into their hearts. Speak to them and warn them about what they are doing. So that is also a type of speech. But that is when it is required. That is when it is required. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is reported that he spoke so clearly and he spoke so well. With us, we need a sound system to enhance the speech. With Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never did he need a sound system. When he was speaking to two, he spoke in such a way that he did not disturb the third person. When he spoke to 100, he spoke in such a way that the person right at the back did not have to twitch his ears to listen, but he could hear. Subhanallah, that was the power, the miracle of nubuwa, prophethood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us even the fulfillment of the sunnah. Then he spoke so clearly, the hadith says, لَوْ عَدَّهُ الْعَادُ لَأَحْصَاهُ. If a person wanted to count the number of words that were being uttered from the blessed lips of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were able to do that. That's how he spoke. Then whenever he uttered something important, he repeated it thrice, so nobody would misunderstand him. Amazing. Not once did any one of the companions look at him and say, sorry, what did you say? Huh? May Allah protect us. We do that because the person speaking, firstly, at times they are not fulfilling the sunnah. And secondly, those sitting have not cleaned their ears. May Allah protect us. Sometimes it can happen. And sometimes people are oblivious, doing other things, not concentrating, whilst something important is being uttered. That also is very, very disrespectful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when blessed words of Allah are being uttered, keep quiet and listen carefully. Listen to what Allah says.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
When Allah's words subhanahu wa ta'ala are being recited, then listen to it carefully and concentrate on what is being said in order for you to derive mercy therefrom. Otherwise you will have no mercy. Imagine the word of the creator of speech itself is being uttered and we are making a noise. May Allah protect us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us, after having made mention of Al-Qawl Al-Baligh in Surah Al-Nisa, where effective speech, powerful speech, some strong statements are being uttered when it is required, subhanallah. Like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is reported, كَانَ إِذَا خَطَبَ إِحْمَرَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ وَعَلَى صَوْتُهُ وَاشْتَدَّ غَضَبُهُ كَأَنَّهُ مُنذِرُ جَيْشٍ يَقُولُ صَبَّحَكُمْ وَمَسَّاكُمْ. When he used to give a lecture on an important occasion to his companions, when he used to lecture on a Friday or at the time of war, he used to raise his voice and it would seem that he was quite angry, and at the same time his eyes would be slightly red when he spoke, subhanallah, because of the serious message, as though he was telling them, look, this is what will happen in the morning and this is what will happen in the evening regarding the army, subhanallah. So at times that is required. But you don't go home and treat your family members like soldiers of an army. No, you speak to them calm, like family members, like children, like wives and daughters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us as sweet as we can within our homes, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this term, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. May you be protected from my harm. That is the meaning of As-salamu alaykum. I guarantee you I won't harm you, and I'm making a prayer for you that the blessings of Allah be upon you and His mercy. That is the greeting. So we should not consider that greeting cheap, and we should consider it in fact an act of worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you want to talk to someone, start off with as-salam. As-salamu qabla al-kalam. You greet first and then you start speaking. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am,
وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ.
When the believers come to you, then first you tell them, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Then deliver the message to them that Allah is most merciful, most forgiving, subhanallah. We ask Allah to have mercy on us, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when someone greets you, you must respond with a better greeting. And if you can't do that, then at least equate it. So if someone were to tell you, As-salamu alaykum, you are meant to respond to them, wa alaykumus salam wa rahmatullah, or wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And if they have got all three, because you receive 10 rewards for each segment. So 1, 2 and 3, 30 rewards. If they have 30, make sure you don't get less than 30. You must also clock the same. If they took 10, why must you just only take 10? Take 30 as well, subhanallah. Imagine someone is dishing out money, may Allah protect us. If the others are only taking 10, if you're allowed, you take more, inshallah. That's regarding wealth and money. What about when it comes to the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We need them. We actually need them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us blessings. So Allah says in Surah Al-Nisa,
وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُمْ بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَسِيبًا.
When you are greeted with a greeting, then respond to it with a better greeting or with an equivalent greeting. For definitely your Rabb, your Lord, is definitely taking account of every minor and major issue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take an easy account of our deeds. So Allah says after that, increase your good words. What are good words? Let me mention some of them mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf. The word insha'Allah is a good word. If Allah wills, Allah says in Surah Al-Kahf,
وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ.
Don't ever say that you are going to do something tomorrow or in the future, except when you have uttered the term, if Allah wills, because Allah is the one in control. And that is the etiquette of a Muslim. You say, I'll come and see you. Say, insha'Allah. So if you want to have good speech, you must add Allah in the equation whenever you are speaking about the future. And whenever there is something good, you've seen something good for yourself as well as for others. Allah says in Surah Al-Kahf,
وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ.
When you enter your garden, you should have said, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. This is what Allah has willed for me. This is what Allah has willed for him or for her. We should be happy whenever we see something good. Let's not become upset at the goodness of someone else, because that also is not a quality of a true believer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the etiquettes of calling someone. When you want to call someone, don't scream, don't shout, especially when they are not children, when they are not your peers, when they are not, so to speak, under your control, when they are respectable, respectful people, treat them as such. Don't scream their name from one corner, hey, come here. That is un-Islamic. The etiquettes require that we go as close as we can to the person, then we call them with a respectful manner. Listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had instructed his companions. He recited this verse because some companions very sadly called him from behind the rooms, very far, and they say, Muhammad, that's not how you call the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no ways. And that is not how you treat the respectful people. You don't call them like that. Allah says in Surah Al-Hujurat,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ.
Those who call you from outside the rooms, when you are inside, and they scream your name from outside, most of them don't even have the understanding.
وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا حَتَّى تَخْرُجَ إِلَيْهِمْ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ.
If they were patient until you came out to them, it would have been better for them. Subhanallah. That is how you speak to the messenger. Then Allah says, that verse was in Surah Al-Hujurat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Nur,
لَا تَجْعَلُوا دُعَاءَ الرَّسُولِ بَيْنَكُمْ كَدُعَاءِ بَعْضِكُمْ بَعْضًا.
This verse has more than one meaning, but let me mention the meaning connected to our topic tonight. When you are calling the Prophet, don't make it similar, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't make it similar to you calling others, because there is a vast difference between calling the respectable Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and calling the others. So that is one of the meanings of this particular verse. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us also that when you are speaking, don't scream and yell and don't raise your voice. Drop your voice. You should only raise it according to what is necessary. So if you are speaking to an army of 10,000 men and you don't have a loud hailer, then obviously you are not supposed to be using this verse that tells you lower your voice and say, you know, the army must listen to what I'm saying. You lose the battle. May Allah protect us. They won't hear what you're saying. You need to raise your voice. But at the same time, whenever you are speaking to one or two people, don't raise your voice as though you are deaf. Normally when people phone the telephone, when they phone someone in Australia, very sadly, psychologically, they think it's far. So they say, hello. And the response comes, how are you? And so on. All that is psychological. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. Lower your voice, they can hear you. Even if you whisper in the telephone, nowadays that apparatus will carry your voice. Subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, really, we ask him to bless us all. I see we're enjoying the topic tonight. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us enjoyment in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Luqman, the son of Luqman alayhi salatu wasalam was given advice by his father. Allah loved that advice so much that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of it in the Quran, because the lesson is for all of us.
وَلَا تُصَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا.
Don't walk with arrogance in this world, O my son. And don't show your cheek to the people, which means don't turn your cheek in arrogance and boastfulness. Don't try and be a person who is above the rest, O my son. And then he says, O my son, and this is advice.
وَقَصِدْ فِي مَشْيِكَ وَاغْضُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيدِ.
When you walk, walk moderately. And when you speak, lower your voice. For definitely, if you were to raise your voice, you would sound like a donkey. He's telling his son. And then he tells his son, and this is quoted in the Quran, the worst sound is that of a braying donkey. May Allah protect us. Because you don't understand what it's saying. It's screaming so loud, you don't even know what it is saying. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us there is a difference between us and animals. When we speak, we'd like people to understand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us good speech. And Allah says, regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again in Surah Al-Hujurat, the lesson was for the Sahaba radiallahu anhum and for all of us. When it comes to respecting our elders and those who are above us, the scholars of this deen, Allah says,
لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون.
Don't you dare raise your voice above the voice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never, don't ever do that. And don't speak to him as though you are speaking to one another. Because if you do that, your deeds might be wasted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never waste our deeds. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, the women folk in fact, Allah tells them, when you speak, don't beautify your voice when there are strange males. No, don't do that. Allah tells us this in the Quran. And this was addressed to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says, don't speak soft. Don't speak softly. For our women, we would translate it differently. We would say, never ever speak provocatively. Go out of your way to make sure that your speech is not provocative. Subhanallah. Allah says in Surah Al-Ahzab,
فَلَا تَخْضَعْنَا بِالْقَوْلِ فَيَطْمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٌ وَقُلْنَا قَوْلًا مَعْرُوفًا.
Don't speak in that soft, sweet female tone to strange males, lest a person who has a disease in his heart might then arouse his own desires and he might get the wrong picture altogether. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. When a female answers the phone, she must be polite and she must not utter or she must not say words that are provocative, and at the same time she must not speak in a voice that will give the wrong picture of who she is and make her cheap. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant honor to all our women inshallah. That's how deep the Quran has gone. Subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how we should be speaking to our parents, the gift of speech. Treat it as a gift. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding parents,
فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا.
Don't ever use the word with your parents. Allahu Akbar. What is the meaning of that? When they ask you to do something out of laziness, you come out and you say, you know, now I don't know, you know, she's telling me so much, and she, no, that is disrespect. Keep quiet, it's better for you. Obey the command and instruction. So long as there is no disobedience of Allah in that instruction, it is a command. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to respect our mothers and our fathers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say,
وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا.
Don't ever be repulsive when you are speaking to your parents. Be careful. It's a major, major sin. No. Repulsive meaning quick to answer back. Quick, quick. You want to answer back. Allahu Akbar. Allah says that will be a means of curse. Those are your parents. Have you not thought your creation is connected through them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah chose to give you those parents. They are the ones, inshallah, whom you will respect at least with your utterances. Don't be repulsive.
وَقُلْ لَهُمَا.
Allahu Akbar. Allah says, and when you speak to them in a proper, polite manner that is full of goodness and politeness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to respect our parents. May He forgive us wherever we've gone wrong. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks, after telling us about our parents, He speaks about a foolish person. And He says, when you are speaking to those who are foolish, then also don't go into deep discussion with them. Just utter a few words and walk away. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa,
وَلَا تُؤْتُ السُّفَهَاءَ أَمْوَالَكُمُ الَّتِي جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ قِيَامًا وَارْزُقُوهُمْ فِيهَا وَاكْسُوهُمْ وَقُولُوا لَهُمْ قَوْلًا مَعْرُوفًا.
I will not go into the whole verse, but Allah says, those who are foolish, when you are speaking to them, then speak to them with good words, with kind words, with words that are full of justice. And then Allah speaks about the orphan. When we speak about the orphan child, let's bear in mind, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an orphan. So naturally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us regarding the orphan in Surah Al-Duha. Most of us know this verse by heart.
فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ.
Don't ever utter anything oppressive to an orphan child. Never. It's a sin. If you want to speak to an orphan, speak properly. Speak polite. Treat them with utmost respect and dignity no matter what age they are of. And Allah says,
وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ.
Don't ever be repulsive when it comes to a beggar. One who is begging, don't be repulsive. Listen, get out. I don't want to give you. No. If you can't, you can look at them, maybe make a sign to them, maybe respectfully try and inform them, tell them, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you when you speak to them with respect. Because if you don't, we don't want to see a day when Allah turns the tables and you have to begin to ask and then people send you away also. Allahu Akbar. We need to think about this. The speech is a gift and we should treat it as a gift, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who then want to give the charity to that beggar or to the orphan or to a good cause, Allah says, don't ever brag about it thereafter. Don't say bad words after that because that will spoil your charity. Allah says, to utter a good word is actually better than a charity that is followed by bad words. To say a good word is better than to give a charity and utter bad words after the charity. You'd rather have not given the charity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us acceptance, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that in Surah Al-Baqarah.
قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذًى.
A good word, قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ, and forgiveness, to forgive others, is better than a charity that is followed by harm. When someone harms, when someone brags, when someone oppresses thereafter, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how the good words go up to Allah. When someone utters good words of dhikr, the good words, the pious words, the words full of gratitude, the words of gratefulness and so on, they go up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are recorded definitely. And a person is rewarded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fatir,
إِلَيْهِ يَصْعَدُ الْكَلِمُ الطَّيِّبُ وَالْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ يَرْفَعُهُ.
The good words are indeed recorded with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why dhikr, the remembrance of Allah, is the best that you could utter with your tongues. One of the best that you can utter with your tongues, the remembrance of Allah. And Allah makes mention of this in Surah Al-Baqarah regarding Hajj, that when a person gets to Muzdalifah, they should engage in more dhikr.
فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا.
Allah says, when you get to Muzdalifah, you should engage in lots and lots of dhikr. More than you would remember your fathers, and more than you would remember anyone else, and more than they would ever remember. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the dhikr that we engage in, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about dua. Dua is the prayer, the supplication. He says to supplicate is also a gift. When Allah has granted you the ability to supplicate, don't be stingy and don't be selfish and don't forget that this world is temporary. So when you are making dua, don't only make dua for this worldly bliss and happiness, but make dua for the grave and make dua for your goodness in the akhirah as well. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ.
There are some people who say, oh Allah, give us in this dunya, give us this and that and that, and they don't even make a dua for the akhirah. Allah says they will get nothing in the akhirah because we will respond to their dua and we will give them what they wanted and we will tell them, you didn't ask for anything for the akhirah. May Allah not do that for us. And Allah says immediately after that,
وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ.
There are some who say, O Allah, grant us goodness in this world, grant us goodness in the life after death, and save us from the torment of the grave. Allahu Akbar. And save us from the torment of the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for them, they will have a portion of what they've asked. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all forms of goodness, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, when you utter a word, make sure it is full of justice. Don't ever say a word that is full of falsehood, because that will result in the curse of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am,
وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعْدِلُوا وَلَوْ كَانَ ذَا قُرْبَى.
Whenever you utter, make sure that it is just, even if it happens to be against your own relatives. May Allah grant us justice, inshallah. So speech is a gift. A person who bears false witness will definitely be taken to task by the Creator. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. Then Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to lies, He says in Surah Al-Anfal,
وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ.
Don't be like those who pay lip service and says, yes, yes, we've heard. And then they are from amongst those who haven't taken heed. They don't actually follow what they've said.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون.
O you who believe, why do you utter words against the actions that you are doing? No, your actions and your words must be equal. Do not engage in hypocrisy. That is also a warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we should abstain from bearing false witness. In Surah Al-Furqan, the verses we read tonight,
وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورَ.
The true believers are those who do not even bear false witness. They don't even want to witness that which is evil and bad, which is unacceptable. They don't even want to witness it.
وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا.
Whenever they are passing by a group discussion or by people who are talking or engaging in that which is evil, unacceptable, or even just a waste of time, the true believers do not waste their time with them. They continue walking and they leave them on one side. And that is known as laghu. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, successful are those who abstain from that which is unnecessary, that which is vain in terms of speech, that which is evil, that which is unacceptable, and that which is a sheer waste of time. If we engage in that which is a waste of time, we will be hindering our success, Allah says. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you hear people talking about Allah and engaging in any form of bad speech, don't be in their company. You must not have friends who don't know how to talk. Don't. Don't even sit with them. If you sit with them, then you are from amongst them. Allah says,
فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ.
Allah says, Subhanallah, if you are to sit with those who utter those type of dirty words, bad words against Allah, against His Messenger, any form of lies and deception, Allah says, when you sit with them, you should never ever be found with those type of people, because if you are seated with them, you are then counted from amongst them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to select our friends, and may we ourselves be good friends to others, because we need to also speak properly, speak that which is upright. If you have a friend who has a habit of lies, believe me, you need to eject him from your circle of friendship, because you will begin to lie without even realizing that now you've become a liar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good friends. And really, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from every form of evil. And this is why Allah says, when there are people who are ignorant, then you just greet them and you carry on. We read the verses tonight in Surah Al-Furqan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the believers,
وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا.
When the ignorant want to talk to them, they just say peace and they walk away. They don't add an extra statement. So much so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues in Surah Al-A'raf to tell us that sometimes when a person is extremely evil, don't even greet him. Walk away. Stay far from him. Subhanallah. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf.
خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ.
Learn to forgive. Learn to forgive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, show forgiveness and enjoin that which is good. and turn away from those who are evil, those who are bad, those who are foolish, those who are terrible company, those who might drop you with them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us very far from those type of people. There were times at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life, in his life, when he did not greet some of his companions for a period of up to 50 days, subhanallah, because of a sin they'd committed, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. And he instructed all his companions to boycott those few people. There were three of them on one instance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of that in the Quran as well. So sometimes, yes, when a person is evil, they've done something extremely bad, it's best to stay away from them. Because if they were to tell you, assalamu alaykum, which means, I guarantee you, I won't harm you. That's the meaning of it. We normally say, peace be upon you. Peace be upon you is a shallow meaning. When we say, peace be upon you from my evil, and peace be upon you from Allah, and peace be upon you in every single way, that is what is included here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, be genuine when you are saying salam. Don't be a fake. You tell someone, I guarantee you I won't harm you. As soon as they turn their backs, you take a knife and you stab them. May Allah protect us. That's hypocrisy. That will cause and create disunity and problems in the ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from those who are hypocrites. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and it's amazing, it's actually extremely powerful, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us of how important it is that when we utter, we must be lenient towards people. When we speak, let's be lenient. Look at a powerful message, one of the most powerful messages. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Taha speaks about sending Musa, Moses may peace be upon him, to Fir'aun, the Pharaoh, Allah says to him and his brother, فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. When you go to Pharaoh, utter very light, calm words to him which are full of softness and leniency so that he might take heed. Subhanallah. Now let's analyze that statement. At that time, who was the worst person on earth? It was Fir'aun. And who was the best on earth? It was Moses, Musa alayhi salam, may peace be upon him. Can any one of us say we are better than Musa? No one on earth today can be better than Musa alayhi salam. He was a prophet. And can anyone say that on earth today there is someone worse than Fir'aun? No, Fir'aun used to say, I am the God. He actually told Moses that, may peace be upon Musa alayhi salam. So no one is worse than him. When Allah sent the best to the worst, Allah says, speak to him nicely. I want to inform you, in our lives, nobody we ever speak to can be worse than Fir'aun. So we're supposed to be speaking even better to them. And nobody amongst us can be better than Musa. So we are supposed to be speaking even better than Musa alayhi salam. We are supposed to be even more careful. So we would never ever be as good as Musa, and we would never ever be going to someone as worse as Fir'aun. So let's be even more careful the way we speak. Subhanallah. You see the power of that message in Surah Taha. It's a very deep verse, though it is extremely short. Subhanallah. It seems like it is just some information of the past, but the lesson derived from it for our speech is extremely powerful. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this verse is in Surah Ala Imran,
وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ.
If you were hard-hearted and if you were hard in your speech, they would have definitely dispersed from around you. But Allah says, it is the rahmah and the mercy of Allah that has made you a lenient individual. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in every single way. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about another very important issue. When someone greets you with salam, don't ever say that, no, this person's not a Muslim. Before we say that someone is not a Muslim, make sure that there is absolutely no sign to associate them with Islam. If there is one sign associating them with Islam, it's enough for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this verse happens to be in Surah An-Nisa,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَتَبَيَّنُوا وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ أَلْقَى إِلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامَ لَسْتَ مُؤْمِنًا.
O you who believe, when you are traveling on the earth, traversing the earth, whether it is in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or you are traveling on the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, make sure that you authenticate and verify. Don't ever say to someone who greets you with assalamu alaykum, this person is not a mu'min. Unless you have verified and you are extremely sure about it, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. And may Allah protect our tongues and mouths. And may Allah never ever make others utter that we ourselves are not Muslims. And may He never make us utter that others are not Muslims. Islam is broad, inshallah. We make dua that Allah grant us acceptance within this huge circle, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us that evil speech, to talk bad about someone, is disallowed except from the person who was oppressed himself. If he thinks he has to, in order to gain back what was usurped from him, he has to utter what was done to him by the oppressor, it is allowed for him to go public with that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this in Surah An-Nisa.
لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم.
Allah does not accept utterance of evil from anyone except the one who is oppressed. If he would like to speak about the oppressor in order to get back his right. So like someone comes here to the masjid and says, you know, there is a very influential individual in your community here who has stolen my money. And he makes that announcement in the masjid in order to try and get that money back, it would be allowed. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never let us see those days, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us in this verse. The warning is actually a different type of a warning. That be careful, don't oppress people. Don't be evil. Because if you are oppressing people, then they may have the right to inform a certain selected group of people who may have authority over you, to tell them what exactly you have done in order to get their right back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. This is why when you go to the courts, if the judge says, what happened? You can't say, no judge, I can't tell you because I'll be backbiting. Allahu Akbar. You need to speak. There's no backbiting there. Allah says, if you are oppressed, you need to tell exactly what happened. Speak, even if it's evil, you need to talk. That's the time you have to talk. This is what is included in this verse as well. Subhanallah. You can't pretend to be so pious that you say, no, no, it's backbiting, you know. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us acceptance and piety, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says that the example of a good word is so powerful in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really, by revealing this verse, brings tears to our eyes. Do you know what example He gives of a good word and a bad word in the Quran? Listen to what Allah says in Surah Ibrahim. Very beautiful, very, very beautiful. Subhanallah. Allah says,
أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا.
Have you seen what type of an example Allah has given?
كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ.
A good word is like a good tree. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. We might not yet know exactly what that example is trying to make of this particular item that is being explained. But listen to what the verse says. Allah says,
أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ.
A good word is like a pure tree, like a good tree. The roots are deep down and the branches are in the sky. Allahu Akbar. So what's so big about that? We need to understand. It is very big. It means the root is depicting this world. The root is depicting the dunya. The earth is depicting this life. And the sky is depicting the heavens and paradise. And Allah says, in this world, you will have a firm standing. You will have respect. The root will go down because you utter good words. You will have that firm, solid standing in society and community. You've uttered a solid word. In this world, you have a solid standing. And when you pass away, the branches are heading straight into heaven because those good words, you will have a full reward for it. So it's like a good tree. Subhanallah. Then Allah says, He continues to say, listen to a bad word. What's the example of a bad word?
وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ اجْتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ اجْتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ.
Allah says, the evil word, the bad word is like an evil tree, a bad tree that has been uprooted from the earth. Now when there's a tree that's uprooted from the earth, it has no benefit in this world, which means there is no root going down. And it doesn't even go up to heaven because it's lying flat and it will rot. Allahu Akbar. If a plant has no root inside, it rots. So when a person utters bad words, they'd rather rot, Allah is saying, subhanallah. And that will return to them. Look at the power of the example of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Allahu Akbar. Then Allah says, and this is by far one of the most powerful messages of the Quran. Allah says,
يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ الظَّالِمِينَ.
Allah says, I will grant steadfastness to those who have been uttering good words in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. I will grant them good words even at the point of death, subhanallah, as well as in the akhirah. So anyone who always speaks upright, Allah guarantees you that at the point of death, He will inspire you to utter La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you stay away from lies, if you stay away from bad mouthing, from bad language, from swearing, from deception, from disrespecting people through the gift of your speech, Allah says you deserve to utter the most valuable statement ever at the point of your death. Allahu Akbar. So if we want to utter these words as the last words as we are leaving, Allah tells us, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ. Allah will make them strong with that word. Allah will inspire them the good word in the dunya as well as in the akhirah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us from amongst those who can utter this shahada. At the point of death, when the pangs of death are overtaking a person, to remember these words is not everybody's job, subhanallah. May Allah make it ours, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us after that, that some of the best of speech belongs to a person who calls towards this religion, who calls towards goodness. Anyone who is calling others towards goodness, anyone who is teaching anyone else any form of goodness, inshallah, they are utilizing that speech in the best way they could, subhanallah. And obviously the best of goodness is this deen of Islam, subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Fussilat,
وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِّمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ.
Who is better in speech? Subhanallah, who is better in speech than the one who is calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And he does good deeds and he says that I am a believer. There is no one who can be better than that person in speech. Subhanallah. We ask Allah to make us from those who can call towards Allah and those who can themselves walk towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whenever you are calling towards the path, make sure you utter good words. Listen to what he says.
ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن.
When you are calling towards Allah, call with wisdom, with tact. One is to have knowledge. A lot of people have a lot of knowledge, but the other is the ability to convey it in a very tactful manner. That is not everybody's job. That requires a lot of experience. It requires sitting at the feet of the ulama of the ummah and learning from them how they have spread the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to be wise. And this is why when a person is young and graduated, they have lots of bubbling energies in them. They want to fix up the whole world because they've learned a lot of knowledge, mashallah. And they go up to everyone and say, no, you, this is not a Muslim, and that person is this, and that person is like that, and this one is like this, and I'm the only one who's right. That is all the energy of youth. No wisdom at all. You might have knowledge, you don't have tact, you don't have wisdom. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Because wisdom will require that you understand that those you are talking to when they are wrong, your job is not to go and despise them. Your job is to try and love for them the goodness that you have and to try and want them to have it as well. So therefore you will employ the sweetest and the best of methods to try and bring them on track, not to go and despise them and call them names, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us. In fact, I take my paper out. There is one more thing that I remember just now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us after mentioning that when you are calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must make sure you utter words of wisdom. And when you speak, when you remind them correctly. And when you debate with them in the best of manners. This is referring to the non-Muslims as well as whenever we are calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But a very important point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited in Surah Al-Hujurat. Scoffing at people, using your own tongue, your speech. Allah gave you a gift, you want to scoff at others. Allah says, don't ever do that. And Allah addresses the women. Allah says, you also, the women folk, make sure you don't scoff at others because they might just be better than you. Allah says that in Surah Al-Hujurat. And Allah says, do not call each other bad names. Do not badmouth people. Do not engage in falsehood. Do not engage in evil. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the same surah, do not defame others. Allahu Akbar, defamation is a crime. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection. Now, at the end of this particular talk, really we make a dua to Allah to have accepted from us the utterances of the Quran we've uttered in salah. To have accepted from us the sitting here for an hour every single night to listen to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to have accepted from us the half of the month of Ramadan. We have completed 15 salahs of Taraweeh in this month. Have we realized that? We are now at the peak, inshallah. From tomorrow, we will be going down the mountain. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from us. Look at how quick it was. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really make this a Ramadan with a difference, inshallah. It is so beautiful to stand in Taraweeh, full of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enjoying listening to Allah's kalam, and thereafter being spiritually elevated by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate us all in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah wa bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.